Hello students, welcome to the class of Editorial Decode, and in this class I will be decoding emulating the US rainbow movement written by Suhirth Parthasarthi. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2. Plus this is very important for sociology optional students. Now what is this editorial about? This editorial is about how the Supreme Court of United States of America has recognized the marriages between the same sex couples. It has recognized, it has given the legality to the marriage between a man and a man, between a woman and a woman. Now, in order to make this editorial understand from the perspective of the mains examination, we need to compare how India has treated its gays community, lesbian, bisexuals and transgender community, because that will make it more important and more amenable from your mains examination point of view. Now, in order to understand how India has been treating its LGBT community, we need to look into the section 377 of IPC. So what does this section 377 says? Section 377 says that even a private sexual intercourse between the same sex couples is a criminal offense. It says that if the same sex people, they will enter, if they will indulge into some kind of intimacy, and that too in private, that will be liable to be called as a criminal act. And the person or the people who will be indulged in this crime, they will be liable to be punished under the Indian Penal Code. And as far as the punishment is concerned, it is to the maximum of imprisonment for life. So this is how the India has been treating, and the Indian law has been treating this LGBT community. Now, in order to properly understand this India's idea about LGBT community, we also need to understand of why this section was introduced in IPC, under whose influence it was introduced. Now this, the introduction of this 377 is generally called as a prejudice of the Victorian era. Now what is meant by Victorian era? Now from the mid of the 19th century to the end of the 19th century, there was a lot of influence of Queen Victoria, and she was a kind of an orthodox lady, and she was kind of a lady which had a lot of prejudices, which had a lot of vices, specifically against the gay community and not against the lesbian community. And it is because of that this section 377 was introduced in IPC, and this act criminalizes any kind of intimacy or sexual intercourse or affinity between the same sex couples. Now, High Court had withheld with this section of 377. It had called that this section is incompatible with the conscience of the Constitution. But as far as the Supreme Court is concerned, it had rejected the verdict of the High Court. Now the present scenario is that the Supreme Court in India, it had said that it is not for the court to go into the validity of the section 377, and it is the duty of the parliament to keep it, to sustain this act, or to abrogate this act, or to delete or to erase this act. Now it is under the purview of the parliament to either delete it or to amend this act. So why India should be amending this act? India should be amending this act because this section 377, it treats the lesbians, the gays, the bisexuals and the transgenders as a community which is not equal with the normal citizens. Now the Indian law, it tends to abrogate this community, it tends to belittle this community, it tends to make the normal men, the women as more superior to the lesbians, gays, bisexuals and the transgenders. Now if we look at the world over scenario, if we look at the complete legal laws that are existing in the other parts of the world, we find that there has been a change that has been introduced. Now all the countries, most of the countries of the world, like the United Kingdom, the Ireland, Australia, now they have amended their laws to allow the marriage between the same sex couples. Now as far as India is concerned, we are still stuck at the stage of decriminalizing the sexual activity between the same sex couples. Now India needs to push itself, India needs to catalyze itself, India needs to reform itself, India needs to be bit more modern and decriminalize this section 377. Now because of the Supreme Court's verdict of United States of America, India mein bhi kya hoga, abhi hum section 377 ko abrogate kar denge. Already a sign has been shown by the Home Ministry and the Law Ministry that this section will be done away with, and uske baad mein abhi इंडिया में सेम सेक्स जो मैरिजेस है उसको लीगलाइज करना बहुत बड़ा इशू है. अभी तो हम इनको पनिश ही कर रहे हैं अगर कोई भी सेक्सुअल एक्टिविटी में इंडल्ज होते हैं. अगर कोई भी गे कपल, लेस्बियन कपल अगर प्राइवेट में भी कुछ करता है तो उसको भी हम क्रिमिनलाइज करते हैं. तो अभी मैरिज की ओर मूव करने वाला बहुत बड़ा फाइट है. सो इट इज अ बिग ब्रिज दैट वी हैव टू क्रॉस, एंड बट इन ऑर्डर टू क्रॉस दैट ब्रिज we need to move one step ahead, and this one step ahead movement involves just decriminalizing the section 377. So this was all for this editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIAS Mentors. You can contact me at 84594 000 000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. And you can visit our websites eiasmentors.com and brainiki.com in case you're interested in availing further information about the classes that we are offering. And you can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainiki. You can find that application from Google Play Store and from App Store. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice night.